This is Arch Obler. In a horrific time, in a horrible world, I have been asked to try and horrify you, all in fun, of course. A challenge in horror, so to speak. Now, I know that you're not a person who is easily frightened. Monsters, ghosts, the dead, who gets scared at that sort of thing anymore? You don't. Or do you? Do you ever think of the undead, the ghostly ones crowded under the gravestones, the restless dead, millions of them there under the ground? May we try something? Turn your lights on. Yes, all of them. Lights out, everybody. Now then, sit down in the chair and turn your back to the loudspeaker. Yes, turn your back. Now sit quietly, very quietly. The room very quiet. Now whatever I say, don't turn around. Remember that. Don't turn around. Do you hear that? Now don't turn around. Something's coming up behind you. Now, don't turn around. It's coming closer and closer and closer. It's something. Oh no. It's very long. Oh, don't turn around. Closer and closer. Okay, the odor of decay. I almost smell it, can't you? Now, don't turn. Putting out its hand toward your neck. Skeleton hands reaching for your neck. Touching your neck. No, you weren't scared, were you?
All right. Oh, age. Dang. Steve Badley, 36.
I'm Jordan Swanseller, and I'm 20 years old.
I'm Richard Whitaker. I'm 55 years old.
My name's Jasmine Ayala, and I'm 27.
Hello, my name is Lynn Hendricks, and I am 18.
Frank Michael Aguilera, and I'm 18 years old.
Tom Stanfield, and I'm 52.
My name is Dustin Miller, and I'm 17.
I'm Andrew Badley, and I'm 27.
I'm a slider.
I'm a dog.
A slider.
I'm the GM at Scandia Family Fun Center.
I'm the casting director, and I'm the mistress of the house that happens to be decomposing.
I'm the assistant casting director, and I'm haunt operations manager. I'm in charge of all things design over the house. And I'm the character of Butcher Bob.
Butcher Bob.
I'm Butcher Bob. Evil, maniacal butcher.
I am a porcelain doll that's severely been beaten up.
My character is, I kind of based it off of Dead Silence, but every night I change my character up. So when you go through the house, we get repeat customers and you don't always get the same reaction.
I call the fire demon. He's very spark based. I had at one point 14 different Razor Scooter sparks throughout my padding.
As you can see, I have an amphibious military look. Basically I'm a gene warped soldier with fish DNA that is a bloodthirsty killer.
Character, I don't really know. A lot of people have called it masky.
Because I love the spark so much, it's developed a little bit of a nickname by the patrons. Called Sparky, which ticks me off because that sounds like a puppy or something nice, and I want demon in there somewhere. But people see me slide and they're like, hey, Sparky, and it really frustrates me. So, self-named fire demon, patron named Sparky.
Yeah, we all do a little bit different stuff, different yells when people come in, using something different. There's knives and cleavers. Some of us use a cleaver, some of us use a knife. Sometimes we kind of switch back and forth.
I'm the ghostly Butcher Bob, and I'm almost dead.
We're supposed to be very simple-minded. I tend to want to get in the face.
in acting when I was 14 years old.
I saw an ad saying open call, casting call, and I just decided to go for it.
I just thought it would be something fun to do.
I heard about it from a friend, and it sounded interesting to me. I just thought I'd give it a try. It was just a spur of the moment.
It's kind of a college internship type deal for me.
Well, I was out playing mini golf with my friends one day, and I looked up and I saw the sign, and I thought it was going to be good.
I came as a chaperone for my daughter, because she's 14.
About a year ago, Steve found out that we were modeling the haunted house that's in Ontario, California, and he wanted me to head it because I had the personality and the experience with Scandia to make it work.
Jasmine called me up and asked me if I'd be a part of it. I was like, yeah, I'll think about that. And then here I am. It's been a blast.
Me and a friend of mine were going through the line originally to just go through and do whatever goes on here. And then we saw the ad and we were like, oh my God, we get to scare people. It is ridiculously fun, and I can't really explain why. It's probably just because it's Halloween and you're supposed to be scared of Halloween.
Yes, very much.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I love scaring people.
I genuinely do.
I always liked scaring my sister. I used to walk around like the Grudge and make the noises when she was watching scary movies, and it was always fun doing that. So, I mean, yeah, I kind of do.
There's just something about the thrill of knowing that somebody is on the knees in tears because of your actions. I'm not a serial killer, by the way. It's just a certain rush.
I do now.
It's just something about the variation of responses, whether it's laughter, terror, screaming, just blood curdling. I mean, but everybody loves it. Everybody loves the scare. They came for the scare, and I just really enjoy it with them.
Nothing is more disheartening for me than putting a full effort into a scare where a slide's good, everything's there, the sparks are flying, the element of surprise. And then to have someone not respond to it, you might as well have been fired for a job. It's just so sad.
I would. It's a lot of fun. You get to meet a lot of people. Like, there's 500 people who I probably would never met if not for this. So it's really cool people.
I would, but not that a fan of art. It's definitely stressful work, but a good kind of stress.
Yeah, for sure. I definitely think anyone who has any inclination, any theatrical bone in your body, haunting's for sure something you should do at least once in your life.
Yeah, very much so.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah. From both ends, whether you're going through it or being a part of it.
Oh, yes, definitely. It's worth it.
Bigger, badder, and greater than ever. Absolutely. Yes.
I'm not really sure. Hopefully I'm going to try to be back next year, for sure.
I'm definitely going to be back next year.
If I can, I just graduated as a drug and alcohol specialist, so I'll be counseling. So if I can work it around that, I'll be working.
Yeah, I think I'd probably be here next year.
Of course.
Yes, I'm going to be on full time if I can. Yes, absolutely.
Thank you guys. Look forward to seeing everyone next year.